So the Cartesian product of two sets can be represented in four different ways. First, RSDG. R stands for roster form, S stands for set builder form, D stands for diagrammatic form, and G stands for graphical form. RSDG. Right? Now, what is the roster form of representation of A cross B? We have already studied these two. The roster form is nothing but you list out all the possible elements of A cross B. 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B, 3A, 3B. So this is the roster form of A cross B. I just list out all the elements of A cross B. That's what roster form is. Next, how do I represent A cross B in set builder form? You don't write individual elements, just write A cross B is equal to a set containing A comma B such that A comes from A and B comes from the set B. This is the definition of A cross B. The definition of A cross B is in set builder form. So as we have seen in set theory, this looks like a set builder form, right? From this, we can build the set. Next, these are the new types of representations that you have. How do we represent A cross B diagrammatically? So now, I represent sets using vowels. So let us say that this first vowel represents set A, the second vowel represents set B. And set A contains the elements 1, 2, 3. Set B contains the elements A and B. Now, A cross B connects the elements of A with the elements of B. So, A cross B, what it does is it connects 1 with A, 1 with B, 2 with A, 2 with B, 3 with A, and 3 with B. So, how many arrows are there? You have 6 arrows, and each arrow corresponds to one ordered pair. So, 1A corresponds to this ordered pair. 1B corresponds to the next ordered pair. 2A connection. This arrow means this point. This arrow means this point. So on. So correspond to each of the ordered pair, you get different arrows. So this way of representing A cross B is called diagrammatic form. And finally, you have something called graphical form. So in graphical form, to represent A cross B, we use a graph. And once you take the graph, the elements of the first set are represented on x-axis. The elements of the second set are represented on y-axis. Like 1, 2, 3. These are elements on x-axis. Let us say that this is the element A, this is the element B. So the elements of the second set are represented on y-axis. Now, each element of A cross B is represented by a point in this coordinate system. So 1A, the ordered pair 1A looks like the point 1 comma A, so that is this point. And 1B is this point. 2A, 2B, 3A, 3B. So A cross B contains these 6 points. This point is ordered pair 1A, this is ordered pair 1B. 2A, 2B, 3A, 3B. So this is called the graphical form of representation. So once you have understood the graphical form, you can see why this product is called Cartesian product, not just product. So why is this called Cartesian product? So once you multiply these two sets, you're getting ordered pairs which looks like points in the Cartesian plane, right? This plane is usually called Cartesian plane, right? So these elements looks like points in the Cartesian plane. That's why this multiplication is called the Cartesian product of two sets. So I hope you have understood how to represent A cross B.